So in previous lecture, we have just discussed how to interface a single key with the microcontroller, and depending upon the position of the key, the LED will on or off. Now we will see another simple application. In this application, we will connect four keys with the microcontroller. And we will connect one 7-segment display to the microcontroller, and depending upon the pressed key, a value 0, 1, 2 or 3 will be displayed over the 7-segment display. So this same example we can extend up to 9 keys, right? 0 to 9. So whichever key is pressed, that number will be displayed. So this is the microcontroller. This is one key. And we will put the label over this key as key number 0. This end we have to connect ground. This is connected to pin number 2.0. This is the second key connected to pin number 2.1. And the label of this key we will keep 1. This is second key number 2, which is connected to, basically this key number is 2, but it is third one, P2.2, and fourth one is this. The label of this key is 3. Connected to pin number, port 2, pin number 3. And here all these connections are connected to plus 5 volt, and all these are 1K. 1K, 1K, 1K resistance, and this end of the key will connect to ground. So these are the input pins. Now what we will do, we will take port 1, and in port 1 we will take lower 4 bits. See, because if key 0 is pressed, then 0000000, this number we will send to port 1, right? Port 1 is having 8 pins, so this will be connected to port 1, pin number 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, right? So this is port 1 pins. If 0, we will press this key, then we will send 0 to port number 1. If we will press 1 key, then we will send 0000001, this value to the port 1. If we will press 2, then we will send value 0000000010. And if we will press 3, then we will send 00, 00, 00, 1, 1. So basically, the lower 4 bits, these are the higher 4 bits of the port 1. These all are 0, right? So we just overlook these bits, but you just concentrate over lower 4 bit of the port 1. This value 0000, you just consider this as a BCD number, right? So 0000 indicates 0, 0001 indicates 1, 0010 indicates 2, 0011 indicates 3. So with these 4 pins of port 1, because we are getting, if we want to display 0123, then we are concerned with only these 4 pins, these 4 bits. So these 4 bits only pins I will use to interface 7 segment display. So here this is port 1, P1.3, P1.2, P1.1 and P1.0. These are the 4 pins, right? The remaining pins of port 2 are these. These are P1.7 to P1.4. So we will not make any correction with these 4 pins. Now these are the outputs. These pins I will connect to a BCD to 7 segment decoder. BCD to 7 segment decoder. 8421 is the binary gate. These are the input to the BCD to 7 segment decoder. Let us say we take this IC 7447. Right? There are two types of, we know that for the 7 segment display, there are two types of 7 segment display. One is common anode type 7 segment display and one is common cathode type 7 segment display. And depending upon the particular type of 7 segment display, we have to select the specific BCD to 7 segment decoder. BCD to 7 segment decoder are coming in two forms, 7447 and 7448. Right? And here the output of BCD to 7 segment decoder are A, B, C, D, E, F, G. And these 7 outputs are connected to 7 segment display. So you just consider this assignment. If we will use 7447 BCD to 7 segment decoder, then this display is of common anode or common cathode. You just find out, right? I am using 7447. Now whether I shall use common anode type display or common cathode type display, you just find out that. Okay. So this particular operation, we will write the code. So now it is very simple. ORG 0000H. First we will scan, we will check the value of this pin. J J GMB P 2.0. Display 0, or I write display underscore 0. So JNB, jump no bit. If 2.0 is 0, when it will be 0? When you will press key number 0. When you will press key number 0, then pin number 2.0 will be connected to ground, right? So whenever it is connected to ground, this means we have pressed the key. And once we have pressed the key, then 0 should be displayed, right? So if pin number 2.0 is 0, then we will transfer the sequence of our program to one label. There we have written a code to display 0, right? So somewhere here we will send a transfer, we will transfer the code DIS underscore 0 at this level. And if we have not pressed this key, right? If we have not pressed this key, this means at this pin we will get 1. So if we will get 1, then so suppose P2.0 is 1, means we have not pressed the key. So JMB P2.0. 2.0 is 0, then only go to this label. Otherwise, don't go. Come to the next instruction. So next instruction is, now I will check next key, JNB P2.1 comma display 1. Now I will check this key. If this key is pressed, then I will send the transfer, I will transfer the sequence of program to a label display 1. There I have written the instructions to display 1. Somewhere here. Otherwise, if this pin is also not pressed, then don't go to this label. Come to the next instruction. In next instruction, we will scan this switch JNB P2.2. If 2.2 is pressed, then go to a label display underscore 2. Somewhere here. And if 2.2, this pin is also not pressed, this pin not pressed, this pin not pressed, this pin not pressed, then check this pin. So JMD P2.3, if this pin is pressed, then we have to display 3, then go to the label display underscore 3. Somewhere here I will write the instructions for display underscore 3. And suppose none of the key is pressed, then first we will check this key. If this key is not pressed, we will check this key. If this key is not pressed, then we will check next key 2.2. If this key is also not pressed, then we will check pin number 2.3. If no key is pressed, then again we will check this key. So if none key is pressed, then S jump scan. Scan is here. Again go back to first pin and check. Now here one thing we have to do. These pins P1.3, 1.2, 1.1, 1.0, they are output pins. But these pins are input pins. So we have to make these pins input. And how to make? To send binary 1 to these pins. So before writing this instruction, we have to make these pins input. So for that I will write instruction move P2 comma hash 0FH. So with this what will happen? 0F. 0F means 00001111 in binary. This value will be transferred to port number 2, and port number 2 means this is pin number 1, pin number 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 of port number 2. Right? So at the pin number 0, 1, 2, 3, 0, 1, 2, 3, we have sent binary 1. Right? By this, we will make P1.3 to P1.0 input. Okay. Now come back to main program. Now you consider a case when we have pressed key number 0. So when we have pressed key number 0 and then our controller will execute this instruction JNB P2.0. So when we press pin number key number 0, so at pin number 2.0 we will get binary 0. So jump no bit means if P2.0 is no bit, is 0, then go to this level. So when we will press this key, then sequence of program will come to level this underscore 0. It will come here. It will come here. So now here what we have to do? First we will verify whether this press was due to noise, or if intentionally we have pressed this key, then we have to remove the bouncing and debouncing time from the key. For that, first we will transfer the sequence of program to a subroutine where we have written a code for 50 millisecond delay. So here L call delay 50 millisecond. So program will go to a subroutine and this delay we have written to some code memory location at 0100H, and here we have written delay 50 ms. So some instructions are there for the delay of 50 millisecond, and in the last we have written the instruction RET. With the written instruction we will come to this place, and here again we will monitor this pin, and if at this point now we will write instruction JB P2.0 go to scan. The meaning of this JB, if 2.0 is 1, if 2.0 is 1 means by noise we got value 0 at 2.0, that's why we have come to this place. If that is the case, then again go back to scan here. Again controller will wheel this loop to scan all these 4 pins. But if intentionally we have pressed the key, then after 50 millisecond delay at pin number 2.0 we will find 0. At pin number 2.0 if we have intentionally pressed the key, then after 50 millisecond we will find a stable 0 at pin number 2.0. If that is the case, if that is the case, then this pin will be 0. If this pin is 0, then jump bit 2.0 means 2.0 is 1, then only go to the scan. But it is 0 now. If it is 0, then program sequence will not go to the scan. It will go to the next instruction. It will come here. So here what we have to do? We have to display 0 at the 7 segment display. Right? For this, simply I will write an instruction here. Move P1 comma hash 00H. With this 00 means this is the lower 4 bits. This is the hexadecimal digit, which is equivalent to 4 binary 0. So equivalent 4 binary bits of this value will be transferred to these pins. So in this case 0 will be transferred, means 0000, and this BCD to 7 segment display will, depending upon this particular input, it will generate the particular value at A, B, C, D, E, F in such a way so that particular section A, B, C, D, E, F, G to display 0, the segment G, G will off and remaining segments will glow and we will see 0. And this 0 has been displayed. Now again go back and again start checking which key is pressed. Now maybe user may press second key number 3, so that again we have to check. So after this S jump scan, again go back to label this. Now again controller will scan all these key, and suppose we have pressed key number 2.1, this key, if we have pressed this key, then due to this instruction the sequence of program will come to DIS underscore 1, this level. And if we come here, again we will send the program to a delay of 50 milliseconds. Here controller will execute the instructions which we will write here to just give a delay of 50 milliseconds. After that, due to RET, we will come back to the main program. Again, we will check pin number 2.1, whether due to noise it was 0 earlier, or if we have pressed intentionally, then we have to remove the that debouncing mechanism, bouncing and debouncing of the spring nature. So again, we will check here jump bit P2.0. If 2.1 now 2.1, if this is 1, this means it was not the press, intentional press over key 1, it was the noise. Due to that earlier we were getting 0, right? So don't do anything, again do the scanning. So in that case go to scan, otherwise display 1. For that move P1, at the P1 we will send the value 01H. Now if we have pressed this key, key number 2.2, then we will come to display underscore 2 here. Here also alcohol delay 50 millisecond, jump bit P2.2, scan, otherwise move to the port 1 a value 02H, and after this S jump scan, S jump scan. Same way for pin number 2.3, alcohol delay 50 millisecond, JB P2.2 scan, otherwise move P1 comma hash 03H and S jump scan. And here we write the delay of 50 millisecond in the same way we have just written in the last lecture. Okay, but here you do one thing, you just for 50 millisecond you just assume that the frequency of crystal is 11.0592 megahertz. In all our previous applications we considered a crystal frequency of 12 megahertz. And accordingly, we calculated the count value required for TH0 and TL0 to generate a delay. But now you consider a crystal frequency of 11.0592 megahertz. So this will be internally divided by 12. So divided by 12, whatever value you will get, that will be the clock frequency for the timer. From that frequency, you find out the time period for the timer. Then you find out the number of pulses required to generate a delay of 50 milliseconds. Whatever number of pulses you calculate, you subtract that from 65,536. Whatever value you will get, that has to be loaded in TH0 and TL0. So you do that calculation and write the program for this delay, right? You just think that why we have taken this very complex value, 11.0592 megahertz. Why we have taken? 12 megahertz was very simple, right? Or 16 megahertz, 24 megahertz. But in most of the system, which is based on 8051 microcontroller, you will find a crystal of 11.0592 megahertz. So this special value, we require when we are dealing with a serial communication, right? When we are transferring the data serially. So when we will discuss the serial communication, at that time we will just discuss at that time what is the relevance or the significance of this particular value, why this value is selected. But for this particular application, to generate a delay of 50 milliseconds, you consider the crystal frequency of 11.0592, and in the last year you write n. So in this way you can write the program. Now here one question is, suppose in some application we require 16 pins, 16 keys. We require 16 keys. So here we have seen for one key, one pin is required. Total how many ports are there in 8051? We know that total number of ports are, I will draw this, total number of ports are 4 ports. Each port is having 8 pins. So in total number of pins are 32 pins. In this way if we go, then we can connect, if we utilize all the four ports for connecting our keys, then maximum we can connect 32 pins, 32 keys. And if we will utilize all the pins of the ports, then we cannot have any pin where we can connect our output device. So this is a problem. To solve this problem, in this type of connection of key in which one pin is required for one key is called as single dimensional key interfacing. Single dimension key interface. So in case of single dimension key interface, one pin is required to connect one key. But now we will move from here, we will move to key matrix. In the key matrix, that is two dimensional key interface. In two dimensional key interface, we will find that number of pins required may be less as compared to the total number of keys. And in practical applications, we use, if we are having more number of keys, then we use two-dimensional key interface only. So that we will see in next class.